Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm coming to give you guys a prom makeup tutorial. So this look is basically just a flawless makeup look with a bold lip. So to begin the process, I just start to apply my primer. I'm using the NYX primer. It's a mattifying primer because I do have oily skin. And now I'm just going on by moisturizing my lips with my CarMax. And also, you guys, all of the products that I use will be in the description bar. So if you're interested in what products I'm using, just be sure to look down in the description bar. So now I'm just going ahead and filling in my brows. You guys can see that I just do very light strokes. Lately, I've been trying to keep my eyebrows a little lighter and not as heavy looking. So that was my goal for this prom look, to get a lighter eyebrow look. Now it's time to conceal. So I'm just using my LA Girl Pro Concealer, and this is in the color Fawn. And I'm just gonna go ahead and outline my brows to get them to the exact shape and the exact size that I want them. So that's what I'm doing now, and I'm basically just sculpting out my eyebrows. And brush through my brows one last time just to make sure they look natural, to give them that wispy natural look in the front, so they don't look too drawn on. So now to cover up the dark bags under my eyes that you guys say I have so bad, I'm using the same concealer, the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Fawn, and I'm just going to go ahead and conceal under my eyes. I did want to try the other LA Girl concealer, the color corrector, the orange color corrector, for my dark circles, but I haven't gotten around to getting that product yet. But I definitely will do a video letting you guys know how I like that new concealer. So now I'm just going in with my beauty blender, and I'm just going and blending everything in, making everything look seamless and smooth. And so I do like to take the concealer up on my nose. It just helps to make my nose look a little bit slimmer without having to contour. I actually don't contour my face at all because I do have a narrow face, so I feel like contouring is not really necessary. So now I'm just going ahead and taking that same concealer, and I'm just going to put it over my eyelids because I do have darkness around my eyelids as well. So I just like to conceal all that so my face can look like it's one skin tone. And I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing around my mouth. It's very typical for women of color to have darkness around their mouths and around their eyes. I'm not sure why, but it's just really common. So this is a step that really, really helps, concealing around the darkness. And I also believe once I do get that orange color corrector, it will help a lot. So now I'm going in with my Ben Nye Banana Powder. I do sell this powder on my website at a discounted price if you guys are interested. I'll leave my website down below and the link to the powder down below. But yeah, so now I'm just going ahead and putting the Ben Nye Banana Powder over all of the areas that I highlighted. Now I'm using this shimmer. It's like a metallic gold eyeshadow. I can't remember exactly which eyeshadow this is that I'm using, but I will leave it in the description bar for you guys. So Yeah, sorry about that. And then I used a brown crease color to blend in this eyeshadow. And you guys, I'm not the best at eyeshadow, but I'm practicing and I feel like I did a pretty good job this time. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and line my waterline with a black eyeliner pencil. So also, I lost the clip when I was doing most of my eyeshadow, you guys. So I'm so sorry about that, you guys. I'm using this big fluffy brush and I'm just gonna go ahead and brush away the rest of the banana powder. And as you guys can tell, by applying the banana powder, it gives you a smooth, flawless finish that I just love so much. And you guys can tell that I don't contour, but when I highlight on my jawbone and when I highlight under my eyes, it brings a dark shade, my natural shade, through. So that's why it looks like I have contoured, but I actually have not, you guys. That's a cool little trick if you guys didn't know that. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and apply my eyeliner. This is just a liquid eyeliner that I've had for the longest. Not even sure what brand it is, you guys. And then I'm gonna follow up with my Maybelline Cat Eye Mascara. And I take a lot of time with my mascara, you guys. I actually edited a few clips out because I'm like, you guys probably don't want to see me putting on mascara for this long. But I didn't have any lashes and I kind of wanted a more simple eye look. So, you know, I left out the eyelashes and I just wanted to do the mascara look. But I do like my mascara very dramatic.
I can tell you're curious. It's written on your lips. Ain't no need to hold it back. Go ahead.
So now I'm going in with this rosy pink blush and I'm just going to go ahead and put that on my cheeks. And then I'm going to go ahead in with my shimmer, my highlight shimmer. I'm going to put this under my eyebrow, on my eyebrow bone, down my nose, and on my Cupid's bow. So I also like to put this highlight right under my eyes, on the corners, and on the top of my cheekbones, just to give me that glow. Now I'm just going to take another fluffy brush and blend out my blush and my highlight together and make sure that it blends in and just looks flawless. So for my lips, you guys, I'm using this NYX brown lip pencil. I'll leave the name down below in the description and I'm just going to go ahead and outline my lips. I found that by using brown lip liners before you apply your lipstick, it helps for everything to just look so much better. It's a very, very good way to have a transition from your natural skin color to your lip color. So now I'm just applying this Wet n Wild red lipstick that I bought from Walgreens, I believe. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply it. So now I'm using my Lime Crime liquid lipstick, and I like to use the liquid lipstick over a regular lipstick because I like the pigmentation of the regular lipsticks, but I like the liquid lipsticks because they do go ahead and give you that finished matte look, and they also ensure that your lipstick stays on all day. So I just love adding the liquid lipstick on top of everything. And then I'm just going to finish off the look by adding a little bit of shimmer on my Cupid's bow again. And that is pretty much it for this prom makeup look, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. So if you guys are interested in seeing more makeup looks like this, then be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, I wanted to conclude this video with a hair tutorial, but I wasn't able to get to it. So if you guys want to see a hair tutorial with this makeup look, then go ahead and let me know down below and I will go ahead and give you guys a hair tutorial that completes this makeup look. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and I will see you guys in my next video. Focus.